Great. Thank you very much for this opportunity. I'm so excited to talk about my research. My name is Miki Yi. I'm a new faculty at Delaware State University. I just joined in January and just survived the first semester. So I'm so glad everything worked out. Today, I'm going to talk about how my research using C. elegans can contribute to human health care. So my expertise lies in DNA repair and maintenance of genome stability. DNA can be changed by the mutations caused by UV, free radical, and certain chemicals. Accumulation of mutations will lead to DNA double-strand breaks and stalled replication forks, and accumulation of that damage and mutation can lead to development of cancers, accelerated aging, or cell death. To avoid such a disaster, genome maintenance mechanisms are so important. So if DNA damage is not repaired, that change in DNA affects signal transduction, and mitochondrial dysfunction may occur, leading to neurodegeneration as well as cancers and aging. This means proper DNA repair system is essential for avoiding neurodegenerative diseases. And what to happen about genome maintenance? If something wrong happens, this is an example about human genetic diseases leading to neurodegenerative diseases called Icardi-Gutierrez syndrome. This is called AGS. AGS is one of the foci of genetic diseases at NIH-NDS. AGS patients are really affected in brains, neurodegeneration, and the problem in immune system and the skin. And these are caused by the mutation in these genes. And TRIX1 is a DNase. And RNase H2 is an RNase. So the cause of this disease is accumulation of abnormal or unnecessary DNA or RNA. And about this gene, RNase H2B, this is a gene we discovered as a DNA repair factor in the first time in the world as a postdoc, when I was a postdoc. And by my research, we are using C. elegans, that's a nematode. And it's a model organism, and we investigate how DNA repair factors and ribonucleases contribute to development, maintenance, and degeneration of neurons, stress response, virus infection, and aging. Today, I'm going to talk about neurons and virus infection regulated by DNA repair factors and ribonucleases. In our neurobiology project, we found that mutations of one of these ribonucleases or DNA repair factors cause various defects in different types of neurons. And we also found that ribonucleases and DNA repair factors are important for suppression of virus replication. We use genetically engineered worms in which a gene cassette of a virus protein and GFP is integrated in the worm's genome, and only when the worm's immune system is compromised, GFP fusion virus protein is expressed. We used gene knockdown by a RNAi technique in this worm, and we looked at the immunofluorescence of GFP. As you see, the gene knockdown of these factors, RNSH2 and Ku80 and ND2, cause higher expression of GFP. This is a negative control, and this is a positive control. So we found that these factors are antiviral protein. And actually, nervous system and immune system are communicating each other and influence each other. So now there is a new field called neuroimmunology. So they are connected tightly. And I'm going to next talk about a new project at Delaware State University in my lab. So we are going to begin a drug discovery project. We are using C. elegans mutant strain as a biosensor. And we want to discover new drugs and chemicals that improve the symptoms of worms' various defects. And why are we using C. elegans? So it's a model organism, and 80% of C. elegans genes are conserved in humans. And small, fast growing, they grow into adult in 3.5 days. And they live only for a short time, only 2 or 3 weeks, total lifespan, and they are highly sensitive to chemicals, and various behaviors can be analyzed easily. And because of that, high throughput screening is good for C. elegans. And we have this equipment, 24/7 automated high throughput screening system. And this is specifically developed for C. elegans, and we use a 96-well microtiter plate. And we can put 10 worms in each well. And we can screen a lot of chemicals at the time. So this was purchased with a fund from Delaware Inglis, a startup fund. Thank you very much. And now we know that many drugs that are developed for one particular disease can be used for curing other disease. For example, Donafanib is a cancer drug, but now can be used for the treatment of dementia. And another example is nilotinib. Nilotinib is a leukemia drug, but now it is effective to treat Alzheimer's disease and Parkinson's disease. And this is a case of natural compounds. Natural compounds of herbs can be useful. This is a good example of that. And this is a herb, Japanese herb called ashitaba. The chemical contained in ashitaba extend lifespan in yeast and C. elegans. So we want to expand this project in this area too. So this is our strategy. So we want to do drug screening using C. elegans mutants. So my lab will be doing this part, and we are going to collaborate with synthetic chemists and small companies. And next is testing in mice. And I'm going to develop a new collaboration. And then clinical trial, we are going to develop another collaboration. And we are going to be focused on virus infection and neuronal functions, including memory and learning and aging. So this is a funding source. I really appreciate all the support. And I actually got award notice yesterday. This is an internal grant at our college. So I really appreciate that. And this is my acknowledgement. Thank you very much.